Well, season's greetings, and thanks for tuning in to a special holiday edition of Wagon Sax. Thank you. Well, happy holidays to everybody out there. Whether you just wrapped up celebrating Hanukkah last week, you're getting ready for Christmas later this week, or you're preparing for the Kwanzaa celebration starting later this weekend, I hope that you're being safe and healthy, and that even though this is kind of a bit of a unique holiday season this year in 2020, that you're able to find a little bit of downtime to relax and enjoy the company that you find yourself in this year more than possibly in years past. It's kind of important that we're able to harness any sort of holiday cheer that we can find this year. Thank you. So last week I put out a new sax cover. I covered a holiday tune, which over the years has arguably become perhaps the most popular song to hear around this time of year. And despite some of the positive feedback I got from some of my friends, I had no idea that there were so many out there who just absolutely loathe this song. So I'm going to do this cover for you next. So this is just a heads up. If you're one of those out there, this might be a good time to go grab a refill on your eggnog or grab some more gingerbread cookies. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I started playing the sax when I was 9, back in grade school. But prior to that, a majority of my musical involvement really revolved around singing in the church choir. And although I don't personally recollect this memory, my mom has told me the story of one Christmas Eve service that we had where the pastor brought me up on stage and had me lead the congregation as we sang Silent Night at the end of the service where they're passing the flame along to everybody's candles. Now, I was very young, so I don't remember this, but it could very well be the first solo musical performance that I gave. And even after all these years, those traditional Christmas hymns that I grew up with back in church are still some of my favorite Christmas songs to hear at this time of year. So I wanted to include a couple of those that I'm going to play for you right now.
Thank you.
Well, I hope everybody's enjoying themselves so far. I kind of put this set together at the last minute. I found myself with a bit more free time than I thought I was going to have this month. See, I have been working as a contract worker for a holiday lighting company through November into the early part of this month. That work was supposed to wrap up shortly after the first week of December, and then I had a flight scheduled on December 17th to go back to Pennsylvania, spend the holidays with my family. But I was feeling a little off earlier this month, so I ended up going in for a COVID test earlier than I expected to, and as 2020 would have it, sure enough, tested positive for COVID. So ended up quarantining the early part of this month, following the news, trying to stay on top of things, and saw that all the health recommendations were coming out to, you know, not gather for the holidays this year. Don't travel if you don't absolutely have to. They recommended against gathering with family members that you don't live within the household with. So again, to be better safe than sorry, I ended up canceling my plans to fly back to Pennsylvania. And ended up with all this extra free time this month, which I have been able to use. I released a couple of songs on my YouTube channel. And I ended up having some time to put this set together. But it's kind of been a unique season, as I have my own set of holiday traditions, as I'm sure all of you have as well. And I haven't been able to participate in a lot of those traditions as I've been cooped up in my place, as I have been for most of the year. As you probably tell, I haven't had a haircut in, I guess, about 11 months now. So as anybody who's known me for a long time knows that my hair used to be even longer than this. But after moving to Arizona, I cut that. It was a little too warm down here to have the long hair. So it's coming back, though, now, as I've been avoiding going to a barber for the last almost year now. So we've all been making our sacrifices. I know our industry in particular has been hard hit, out of work. Not just the musicians, it's all the people that back us up too. The sound engineers, lighting techs, riggers, roadies, stagehands, stage managers, activity directors, program directors, ticket takers, concession workers. And if, whether you're going to a big concert at a stadium or you're just going to see your local band play at, you know, the dive bar, you know, there's all sorts of people working to make that happen, not just the people on stage making the music. So been a hard year for everybody, and it makes this holiday season kind of unique, as I always like to, you know, reflect on the previous year and look forward to the year coming up, you know, especially that week between Christmas and New Year's. And it's difficult this year to do that and not kind of get even more frustrated, as there's not a whole lot of positives to take away from the previous 11 months. So it's been a challenge for me to kind of pull from the last 11 months, you know, and maybe look more towards what I personally and we as a people have overcome, the obstacles that we've gotten over, you know, the way medical science has progressed with the vaccine coming out, and the way people were able to adapt and shift their careers to their home office as opposed to going out to their actual jobs. And all the parents out there who are now acting as teacher's aides, you know, helping to teach their kids from home, have no other choice. You know, it's just as big of obstacles as those really are, they're also huge accomplishments. And I think that's something we can kind of pull away from this. So as we approach the new year, as we approach 2021, I'm optimistic things will turn around and hopefully we'll start to see some more positives moving forward. And as we approach this time of year, there's, you know, the song you always expect to hear at the New Year's party. It's a song I always enjoy performing because it kind of gives me that sense that the new page is turning. And although it doesn't mean you've got a clean slate and it doesn't erase the things that have happened over the last year, hopefully it's symbolic in that it can kind of usher in a little bit of hope that there might be a new page turning. So this is Auld Lang Syne. Mm-hmm. Well, thanks again for joining me this afternoon. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you get a chance, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's where I keep all of my original material, covers, arrangements, compositions. And I wanted to take one last opportunity just to wish everybody out there a happy holiday season. Please stay safe, stay healthy, be smart, and although it can be hard at times, try to love each other. Mm-hmm.